Christian will have grace with hips wide enough to hold the world and all of her differences. The revolution won't be on Facebook. You won't see a status update that says wake up. You will have to go where most men have never gone before. Reach beyond your egos, children. Seek to know thyself more. The revolution won't be on BET. So if you go looking for it there, that won't be where it is, won't be where it be. The revolution, it will not be televised, will not be televised, because commercial airtime is expensive, and we can barely afford to pay for gas, groceries, and rent. Barely trust our government with the delicate care of our being, because of news reports we're seeing. We remember being the other.
The outcast, the murderer. The self-sacrifice won't be seen for your own survival. No, the revolution still won't be televised. First of all, because it begins in your own mind. When you decide that you deserve to be treated humanely. When you believe that you deserve the opportunity for upward mobility. When you decide that your oppressor doesn't have the right to deny you basic human rights. We don't see the real massacre. We don't know the true numbers of those who have been slaughtered because Big Brother has decided that we can't handle the truth. So they simply hide it from you. You know, the revolution won't be available to you for download on Hulu, Netflix, pay-per-view, or YouTube. Nor will it win top honor at the Cannes or Sundance Film Festivals because it's no festival for them. No picnic either. Because the real revolution occurs where journalists can't follow. It's a place where even camera phones don't dare go. See, to us, it's just news coverage that does nothing to uncover the real reality. See, to us, it's just a story. To them, it's their daily tragedy. The revolution is a single mother. Three kids, two jobs, one friend. This is the journal truth that Harriet Tubman meeting by candlelight. Betty Shabazz, Bernie Evers, Coretta Scott, King, Up, Sleepless Nights. This is labor. Babies born from wombs, crafted with bent, broken dreams. We release you from our bodies, trusting the womb to watch over you. This is Trayvon Martin walking home in the rain. I'm the Negro, Sean Bell, and the tale. We, the mothers, sisters, daughters, who held you before you even took form, rocked you in our arms before you could speak or walk or write. Brother, this revolution will not be done for you. Stop waiting to wake up one day and the world has magically changed overnight. No one will write this poem for you. No one can make your feet dance or march or move. This is not a movie. There will be no paparazzi, red carpet, no entourage, no movies. There is no room for Hollywood idolatry and conversation about freedom. This is not a mainstream consumer-based voting event, not sponsored by Nike or Nokia, not a reality show. This is reality. Where Kardashian is a household name, but Mumia Abu-Jamal is not. Where an afghan of Botox costs enough to feed a dozen homeless families, the revolution will not be featured on the cover of Pico magazine. Not posted on billboards on Sunset Boulevard or a pop-up window on your internet homepage. There will be no waiting for Oprah to validate your presence on the planet or Donald Trump to buy you your freedom. This is a world where the prison industrial complex legally enslaves black and brown, where mothers, sons are shipped off to war.
Poor people killing poor people, killing poor people, killing poor people. Poor people killing poor people, killing poor people, killing poor people.
We remember being the other.
The outcast.
The murderer.
The revolution will not be.
The revolution won't be televised,
because we know they're watching, and so we watch God.